अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आवर सेकंड लेक्चर इन विच वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप। वी विल ट्राई टू चेक टू स्टडी ऑल द लीडरशिप टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप, डिफरेंट स्टाइल ऑफ लीडरशिप। देर आर फोर मेजर टाइप्स ऑफ लीडरशिप, बट इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल गो थ्रू एंड वी विल ट्राई टू कवर ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप। नंबर वन, ऑटोक्रेटिक लीडरशिप। ऑटोक्रेटिक लीडरशिप स्टाइल इज सेंटर्ड ऑन द बॉस। इन दिस लीडरशिप द लीडर्स होल्ड्स ऑल अथॉरिटी एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। इन दिस लीडरशिप लीडर्स मेक डिसीजन ऑन देयर ओन विदाउट कंसल्टिंग सबॉर्डिनेट्स। दे रीच डिसीजंस, कम्युनिकेट देम टू सबॉर्डिनेट्स एंड एक्सपेक्ट प्रॉम्प्ट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन। एंड ऑटोक्रेटिक work environment normally has little or no flexibility. In this kind of leadership, guidelines, procedures and policies are all natural addition of an autocratic leader. Statistically, there are very few situations that can actually support autocratic leadership. So in this leadership, we can say that it is type of a martial law condition. A single leader who have all the power center in that person, and he has to decide the fate of whole of the people. But this leadership almost don't have the support of a common man, obviously, because this is an autocratic type of leadership. अमूमन इसमें इस leadership में ऐसा होता है कि ज़ाहिर है एक आदमी जब तमाम लोगों की फेट के किस्मत के फैसले कर रहा हो तो बहुत से लोगों की नापसंदीदगी भी उसमें शामिल हो जाती है। लेकिन बहरहाल क्योंकि ये लीडरशिप ताकतवर होती है, लिहाजा अपने फैसले को इम्प्लीमेंट कराना जानती है और जो भी उसके ऑर्डर होते हैं उनको फौरन उन पर अमल कराना चाहती है। नंबर सेकेंड, जो हमारी पॉलिटिक्स की सबसे फेवरेट लीडरशिप है, डेमोक्रेटिक लीडरशिप। इन दिस लीडरशिप स्टाइल subordinates are involved in making decisions. Unlike the autocratic style, this leadership is centered on subordinates' contributions. The democratic leader holds final responsibility, but he or she is known to delegate authority to other people who determine work projects. The most unique feature of this leadership is that communication is active upward and downward. With respect to statistics, democratic leadership is one of the most preferred style of leadership, and it entails the following: fairness, competence, creativity, courage, intelligence and honesty. So democratic leadership, you may say that it is the people, it is almost discussed in that this is the more applicable and more simple leadership, and it is liked all over the world. The currently this is the era of democratic leadership, we can say, and it the democratic leadership carries fairness, competence, creativity, all the major attributes of any government centered in this democratic leadership. Number third, strategic leadership style. Strategic leadership is one of that involves a leader who is essentially the head of an organization. The strategic leader is not limited to those at the top of organization. This style geared to a wider audience at all levels who want to create a high performance life, team or organization. The strategic leader fills the gap between the need and a new possibility and the need for practically by providing a prescriptive set of habits. Effective strategic leadership delivers the goods in terms of what an organization naturally expects from its leadership in times of change. 55% of leadership normally involves strategic thinking. Sports is clearly an area where we can observe many leadership style, and one of which strategy is crucial. So strategic leadership is something that it is an head of organization, and it is a specific authorities in that specific organization. So it is not an overall a complete leadership, and this is only the headship or leadership of a small organization. And in sense, we can say that it is all about any economic or the other institutions. Transformational leadership. Unlike other leadership styles, transformational leadership is all about initiating change in an organization, groups, oneself and others. Transformation leaders motivate others to do more than they originally intend, and often even more than they thought possible. They set more challenging expectations and typically achieve a higher performance. Statistically, transformational leadership tends to have more committed and satisfied followers. This is mainly so because transformational leaders empower followers. William Edward Deming, a statistician and engineer, is a leader who saw the best way certain systems could operate and taught those under him how to accomplish these goals. This is the man, William Edward Deming. स्टैटिस्टिशियन है, अमेरिकन है, एक इंजीनियर है, एक काबिल आदमी है. सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर के बाद जापान की रिहेबिलिटेशन में, उनकी इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज में इस आदमी ने आके काम किया, बड़ी मेहनत की. आज भी जापानीज इसकी बड़ी इज्जत करते हैं, लोगों को बड़े बड़े टास्क दे के और उनसे बड़ी बड़ी जिम्मेदारियाँ देकर उनको फ्री कहा गया कि आप अपने काम में आज़ाद हैं, आप जिस तरह ये काम कंप्लीट करेंगे. लेकिन एक्सपेक्टेशन और अमाउंट ऑफ वर्क उनको ज़्यादा दिया गया और उनसे ये कोशिश की गई कि उनसे मैक्सिमम ग्रैब किया जाए, और ये इसमें बड़ा कामयाब रहा. और आज भी जापानी कौम इस आदमी को अपना मोहसिन समझती है. टीम लीडरशिप इन्वॉल्व इन सर्टन ऑफ अ विविड पिक्चर ऑफ अ टीम्स फ्यूचर which is heading and what it stands for. The vision inspires and provides a strong sense of purpose and direction. Team leadership is about working with the hearts and minds of those involved. It also recognizes that teamwork may not always involve trusting cooperative relationship. The most challenging aspect of this leadership is whether or not it will succeed. According to Harvard Business Review, team leadership may fail because of poor leadership qualities as well as the other challenges. For example, an airline flight crew would be much more efficient if the team remained consistent. So we can say that team leadership it is a type of working relationship, we obviously call it. And if the whole of the branches of an institution are working in a teamwork, and they have all the departments are working positively, so it will make a good development in that sector. Number 6, cross-cultural leadership. This form of leadership normally exists where there are various cultures in the society. The leadership has also industrialized as a way to recognize front runners who work in contemporary globalized market. Organizations, particularly international ones, require leaders who can effectively adjust their leadership to work in different environments. Most of the leadership environments in the United States are cross-culture because of the different cultures they live and work there. One example of cross-culture leader is sports in quarterback and Heisman Trophy winner Mariota Marcus. His Hawaiian background caused him to an unpretentious player. He contrasts to being a more aggressive one, yet he is still successful. So this form of leadership is almost, which this leadership tries to gather the different groups of the people in a single leadership. They work in different environment, they know the point of view and the mental condition of each and every groups, and they try complete their goals while living in all the different cross-culture people, and they this kind of leadership put all the people onto a single point. Facilitative leadership is dependent on measurements and outcomes, not a skill. Although it takes much skill to master, the effectiveness of a group is directly related to efficiency of its process. If the group is high functioning, the facilitative leader uses a light hand on the process. On the other hand, if the group is low functioning, the facilitative leader will be more directive in helping the group run its process. An effective facilitative leadership involves monitoring group's dynamics as well as offering process suggestions and interventions to help the group stay on track. Laissez-faire leadership gives an authority to employees. According to ancestral departments of subordinates are allowed to work as they choose with minimal or no interference. According to research, this kind of leadership has been consistently found to be least satisfying and least effective management style. But to a certain extent, delegating is necessary. Famous historical projects led by laissez-faire leaders include the building of Panama Canal and Hoover Dam. With both projects, the presidents involved had to delegate many responsibilities in order to succeed. In this kind of leadership, the subordinates are given allowed to work and choose with their own will whether how can they complete that project. The Hoover Dam and Panama Canal is also the example that the engineers and the rest of the working cadre people completed this project with their own will and with least resources. But when they were given responsibility and liberty to complete it, and they were the trust and the all of we can say the trust that was given to the workers, they were encouraged to work with their own will, with least resources, but yet they completed that project. 9. Transactional leadership. This is the leadership style that maintains or continues the status quo. It is also the leadership that involves an exchange process whereby followers get immediate tangible rewards for carrying out the leader's order. Transactional leadership can sound rather basic with its focus on exchange. Being clear, focusing on expectation, giving feedback are all important leadership skills. Transformational leadership behaviors can include clarifying what is expected for followers, performance, explaining how to meet such expectation, and allocating rewards that are contingent on meeting objectives. Coaching leadership involves teaching and supervising followers. A coaching leader is highly operational in settings where results, performance require improvement. Basically, in this kind of leadership, followers are helped to improve their skills. Coaching leadership does the following: motivate followers, inspire followers, and encourage followers. Some examples of people who led through coaching are tennis coach Nick Politeri and dog behaviorist Cesar Millan. This man Nick is a coach of tennis and very successful coach of tennis, and he represented many players. While the behaviorist dog behaviorist Cesar Millan, he is a man who almost behaviorist with the dogs. ये आदमी कुत्तों को पालता है, उनको सिखाता है, उनको मुख्तलिफ करतब करना सिखाता है, और बड़ा कामयाब जो आम तौर पे इंटरनेशनली जो कुत्तों के मुकाबले होते हैं छलांगों के और इस किस्म की एथलेटिक सीजन के, उनका बड़ा माहिर है और कुत्तों से बड़ा फैमिलियर भी है. Number 11 है जी charismatic leadership. In this type of leadership, the charismatic leader manifests his own her revolutionary power. Charisma does not mean sheer behavioral change. It actually involves in transformational of followers' values and benefits. Therefore, charismatic leaders are not merely a simple populist leader who affect attitudes towards specific object. Rather, these leaders transform the underlying normative orientation that structures specific attitudes. Charismatic leaders tend to have powerful personalities and attract huge followings. Example of such leaders are Barack Obama and Oprah Winfrey. Barack Obama is American president, you know, and Oprah Winfrey is a lady who handles a show and handles a very big NGO. It is almost the owner of that NGO and very active lady. It also holds a show of Oprah Winfrey. ये खातून एक अमेरिका में शो भी करती है, बहुत बड़ी एनजीओ की मालिक भी है और खासी अमीर खातून है और बहुत ज़्यादा फलाही काम भी करती है. बराक ओबामा एक ऐसा लीडर था जो नोवेयर फ्रॉम नोवेयर बड़े अरसे बाद मार्टिन लूथर किंग के बाद एक करिज्मेटिक लीडर सामने आया और उसने अकॉर्डिंग टू अमेरिकन राइटर्स बड़ा अच्छा डिलीवर किया. डिलीवर करिज्मा यही है कि लोग उसके पीछे अंधाधुंध उसकी सलाहियतों को देख के, उसकी काबिलियत को देख के, उसकी तमाम अफाल को देख के जो उसको कॉपी करते हैं, उसको फॉलो करते हैं. यही करिश्मा है लीडरशिप का. नंबर 12 विजनरी लीडरशिप. दिस फॉर्म ऑफ लीडरशिप इन्वॉल्व्स लीडर हु रिकॉग्नाइज द मेथड स्टेप्स एंड प्रोसेसेस ऑफ लीडरशिप आर ऑल ऑब्टेन्ड विद एंड थ्रू पीपल. Most great and successful leaders have some sort of vision for where they are going. However, there are those who are highly visionary in their leadership. Example of leaders who had powerful and inspirational visions include Nelson Mandela and Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Outstanding leaders will always transform their visions into reality. Visionary leader means that what is in your mind, you have to transform that vision into your realities. जो आपके जहन में जो तखयलात हैं, जो ख्यालात हैं, जो आपके ऑब्जेक्ट हैं, गोल हैं, जिनको आप हासिल करना चाहते हैं, उनको सही मानों में उसको तब्दील करना, अपने ख्वाबों को हकीकत में बदलने का नाम विजनरी लीडरशिप है. ये हमेशा वो लोग हैं जो खासे काबिल होते हैं और वो अपनी कौम के लिए, अपने लोगों के लिए आने वाले दौर में बेहतर से बेहतर की तलाश के लिए रहते हैं और वो अपने ख्वाबों को हकीकत में तब्दील करने की सलाहियत रखते हैं. सो दिस इज़ आवर सेकंड लेक्चर एंड इंशाल्लाह वी विल गो थ्रू विद आवर थर्ड लेक्चर वेरी सून. आई एम सेंडिंग यू ऑल्सो द हेल्पिंग मटेरियल ऑफ दिस लेक्चर. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.